you think we're you're so the seventh happy. Brady kid. Such Five decades later, they are still moving, grooving, and singing. The Brady Bunch first premiered back in 1969 and, of course, secured a place in pop culture history in our hearts.
Yeah, I know people at home are singing that song, y'all. I just want you to know that. And over time, the Brady house has become just as iconic as the family that lived there. Well, now the six Brady siblings are back together for a retro restoration of that classic piece of real estate on HGTV's A Very Brady Renovation.
Well, if you can't tell, we are just so excited and thrilled to be joined live by Barry Williams, Maureen McCormick, Christopher Knight, Eve Plum, Mike Lookinland, and Susan Olson. Brady's, good morning.
Hi, guys.
Good morning.
Now, is it going to be weird if we just call you Greg, Marsha, Peter, Bobby, Cindy?
Like, it easier for us.
Exactly. We wouldn't be the first to do that, right?
Well, one of the interesting things is the show has never been off the air since we started in 1969, so that's a lot of reinforcement in Greg and Bobby and Peter and Marsha. So,
thank you for understanding.
Yes,
when you're walking down the street, I can only imagine what people say to you. What's the number one thing they say? I'm going to ask each one of you quickly. Number one.
They say it's a sunshine day.
They want to sing it?
That, oh, my nose.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
What's yours, Peter?
Can you say pork chops now?
Yeah. Yes.
Here's your change, ma'am.
Yes, that's right.
Don't play ball in the house.
That's right. Yeah.
Get off my lawn.
Yeah, I love it. I know. We were thinking that there was another phrase maybe that you had heard before, Jan.
Everybody says it over and over. Yeah. I don't know if you're sick of it.
Yeah. Jan. We want to reclaim it for you.
I like that.
Right? Forget Marsha.
Why do you think that was the phrase that stuck? Like, that was one of those weird things.
I have no
things.
Idea. It's
why do you think?
Because it was done on Saturday Night Live. A gal was portraying Jan as this really goofy person, and that was what started the popularity of that clip.
And you know what? Because I think everyone connects with you and understands what it's like to
be Jan. I was Jan.
We're Jan,
but what
and everyone else is Marsha.
And applesauce.
Yes.
Right. It's not like a person in Australia spoke to somebody in the United States back in late 70s and decided that was an important line for them.
Right.
And somehow it triggered something.
Right.
You couldn't have anticipated that.
Yeah.
Now, you were saying, Marsha, that, Maureen, that you guys don't get to really get together like this all that often.
Yeah. Right. It's been a really long time since all of us have been back together.
Years. Yeah.
Wow.
But, you know, I really think, too, I think, you know, everyone looks at the projects as they come. And this one, I think, just got
this
us
was
all.
A great idea.
You know, it was HGTV who, you know, their programming is amazing.
Yeah.
This whole show is filled with so much love.
Yeah.
The crew, everybody behind it, it's a work of love.
We should mention what it is.
Yeah, so you guys are taking the house that we used to see that opened the show every day, but it was never a house you guys actually lived in.
Right.
That,
never.
Right, that was
right, it was one-story house.
It was a one.
Yeah.
So you decided you were going to take that house with HGTV
and renovate
it. They did.
I wish I would have thought of it.
So each of you is renovating a special room in the house?
Right.
Is that how it works?
Along with the HGTV stars, the Property Brothers, and so much great help there as far as design goes. And they're very specific about what goes in the house. They are trying to make it look exactly like the set, down to the wallpaper.
Yeah.
Didn't you
yeah.
guys have special wallpaper?
Yeah, made? Well, you know, yeah. I oversaw that.
Yeah, wow. Yeah. Where they have us staining cabinets and hammering nails and cut. I mean, we're
now, are any of you handy? I mean, I think Mike/Bobby, you are, right?
I was assigned the master bedroom.
Oh.
And I immediately said, well, Bobby never went in there, so, you know what?
Yeah.
They're working around all our schedules.
Yeah.
And they're working around the HGTV people's schedules as well. And they're doing such a great
job.
So
are they doing
the
staircase?
Yes.
Yes.
Have you seen
the finished product?
No. Soon. Very soon.
From the outside, the house looks completely the same.
Wow.
But now there's two stories.
There's a nationwide search for the horse that goes in the living room.
You're kidding me.
Right? Yeah, because we're trying to find that. And one of the nice things about the show will be the sentimentality of it, the nostalgia, because when we're going in the rooms, we're reflecting on what happened and the scenes that we played.
Did you have any memories? Maybe a stolen kiss between you know who?
Flooded with memories.
Yeah.
How many stolen kisses were there?
Yeah. Susan and I built the doghouse the other day.
Yeah. You did.
And then we made out in it again.
You did. Just like, you know what struck us? We can't believe this show was only on for 5 seasons.
I know.
And yet had such an incredible, left a mark on so many generations.
There were so many other shows. We had a cartoon show. We had a variety hour. We, you know, we had all these
Very
reunions.
Brady Christmas.
Yeah.
Brady girls got married.
Well,
Brady
as you said, Barry, it's never not been on the air. You could see it on, you could turn it on today.
Right. Yeah.
Do you ever watch it? Any of you guys?
Do your kids watch it?
My, you know, I wish my kid did. Yeah. Because I think it's a wonderful show for children to watch.
It is.
Because it instills a lot of great values that you're not finding in shows these days.
Over the years, has there, I'm sure you've all been through, you know, ups and downs in life. Has there ever been a time where being a Brady felt like a lot to carry?
Yeah.
I want to toss that one to Maureen.
I mean, yes, of course. And I think, you know, I would look at that show and then I'd go, well, real life is not like that at all. And
she was not like Marsha.
No. And you think that people, you know, are expecting to see that or whatnot. But
and you're adolescent and you're trying to find your real place in the world.
Right.
It's a tight fit.
Instead of your TV place.
Yeah.
But I mean, seriously, I just am so grateful to have been a part of that show that it's in so many people's hearts everywhere.
Forever.
And it makes people feel good.
Yeah.
How lucky are we to have been a part of that?
Exactly. Well, people may be looking at this group saying, I wonder what they're doing now. So will you just go down and just tell us what you've been up to?
All different things. Yeah. Mine is music-oriented. I have a trio called The Travelers and travel around the country performing and playing.
That's so great.
Cool.
That's so you. You always were a musician.
Yeah. Living the Johnny Bravo dream.
Yeah.
Yes, you
Bravo.
Are.
Oh, my gosh.
Totally.
Okay.
My biggest accomplishment is I just celebrated 34 years of marriage to my dear husband, Michael, and we have a beautiful daughter together, Natalie, and love my family, very involved with my brother who has special needs, working in production right now on a film, and have a couple things in the works.
Oh, okay.
Still working as an actor, and also now I'm also a businessman and created a brand out of myself, Christopher Knight Home. It's a furnishings brand, and a new extension to that brand, Christopher Knight Collection.
Cool.
Oh, you got to get some stuff in the Brady house, just secretly, even though it's not the right time period. What about you, Eve?
I'm still acting. I was just on an episode of Crashing on HBO. Mm-hmm. Been doing some regional theater here in New York and outside. Also, you know, renovating houses that I've lived in. Done a lot of
like
that myself.
It's like a perfect fit.
It's really nice. It's a perfect fit. How about you, Mike?
I'm also married 30 plus years.
Wow.
To the same person.
Sweet cow,
To the same person.
Not the same counselor, but the same person as, you know.
Yeah.
I run a small company, and if they're watching.
An amazing company.
If my clients that are trying to get a hold of me are watching the Today Show, they'll know why I'm not at home working for them.
What does your company do?
We make
I'm one of those clients. I can't get a hold of them.
Yeah, exactly.
We make architectural concrete, which is mainly tables and countertops.
How cool.
It's fun.
Gosh, this was in your wheelhouse, the HGTV show.
It really was.
How about you, Susan?
I've been a graphic artist. I teach acting for kids, and my universe is my son, Michael, who's in a wonderful band. He's playing bass with Xyrolithia.
Wow.
Oh, so much fun catching up with
really
you guys.
Nice
we're excited for your Thank new you. Show, and we're also excited because you guys are going to come back with Jenna and me and hang out on the fourth hour.
Yeah.
Nice.
It's a date.
Nice. Yeah. It's a date.
They have fun. I guess you just are used to everyone smiling and beaming at you because you're just in our hearts.
You.
Thank you so much.
What could be wrong with that?
Exactly.
We really love having you here. Thank
you.
In fact, we're not letting you go. You have to come back on the fourth hour. Don't forget, A Very Brady Renovation will premiere on HGTV in September.